current events. Mr. Howard?
Okay. This just in from the Presbyterian Young Professionals, who had a party in the Pines a couple weeks ago, and PUSDF Foundation was the beneficiary. Last year, they raised $12,000 for us. This year, $25,000. They'd like to come in August and present to the foundation at our board meeting. I think that would be just fabulous, so we'll get to thank them personally. All summer long, as you know, we're watching enrollment closely, so I wanted to give you an update. Right now, Lincoln's looking, you know, starting to get pretty full across the board, and that's been the case for a couple of years now. So we'll be watching that closely. We're making phone calls right now because people enroll in February and then make different decisions and don't let us know. So we're following up to see if those numbers have changed. If not, we may be talking about some staffing solutions. And in looking at Lincoln now for a few years in a row, being full, and that's growing up through each grade level, we may look at some boundary changes over the next year, certainly not before this year. So we'll look at some staffing solutions for that. We're talking closely with the caregivers about that. Kindergarten is looking very strong across the whole district. And those are our, you know, typically our lowest class sizes, that we try to keep them the lowest, and so we're keeping an eye on that. It's a trickier solution when it's high across the district. You can't just plop one into a school and solve all that. So, but we've got some pretty creative solutions for those things. So we'll be in touch on those as we see how those trends are going. Also, too, if you may have driven by Lincoln and seen there's a new playground there. And so we're all set with the pre-K there. We're going to have a pre-K classroom run by Discovery Gardens, but it's a part of Lincoln School. And it'll be downstairs there. So that's part of our neighborhood satellite concept from Discovery Gardens, where in all of our elementaries, kids will be able to start their preschool career. It's working beautifully. Taylor Hicks, we put two sections over there this year. They're eating lunch with the big boys and girls if they want. Our specialist teachers have carved out some time to go in and start to teach them what they do also. So it's a neat match that's worked really well. And then next year, we intend to expand that to a biogen. We're always looking also at hard-to-fill positions. Our staffing turnover this year was stabilized kind of for the second year, around a little less than 30 teachers that left. And so that's typical for PUSD over the span of about 20 years. 3 and 4 and 5 years ago, we had a tough time. We were losing 60 around there. So that's stabilized. But that said, we have 10 positions open still. We call those hard-to-fill positions at this point in the year. They're very specialized positions, special ed positions. We've got a couple choir positions, that type of thing. So we're working hard and being creative on how to fill those. So everyone put your feelers out there and send them our way. I wanted to point out, many of you probably know this, Grapes for Grades, put on by the Prescott Frontier Rotary, will take place at Waters on the 24th. That pays for our summer school, 24th of June. Coming up here.
This Sunday?
Okay. So put that on the radar if it's not. And then a couple calendar dates, important ones, first day of school, August 2nd. And convocation, July 31st. We're working on some neat ideas for that. We got a little time, but it'll go fast. That's it for me, Mr. President.
All right. That's a lot.
It's
been a busy past couple months.
Yeah.
Busy summer. So
yeah.
Board members, anything?
Had a nice time at the Summer Leadership Institute.
Thanks for coming.
There's good courses as usual. The interesting thing, the ASBA president was from Santa Rosa, California, where they had all the fires. Well, they lost a school during one of those fires, and he did mention a good idea is to have every teacher videotape their room in case of disaster. I thought, we're not doing that.
Yeah, that's a great idea.
But he also said have the teachers share it with the other teachers. They get ideas on how rooms are set up and things like that. So something they want to play with and think about.
Love
one
it.
Thing I pulled away from the meeting. Other than that, it was a good meeting. Major, you know, topics to speak of. Well attended.
Thanks for
representing. Sure.
Well, it wasn't too long ago, graduation from high school. It was just a couple weeks ago, and it was a great night. It was really fun, went really well, so was a good finish to the school year. Anything else? All right, let's move on to the consent agenda. Anything in regards to the consent agenda? There's a lot of items that we need to discuss specifically.
I would just like to recognize that with the donations, the generosity of the community is overwhelming. The Jewish Community Foundation, the Kiwanis Club, individual donors, it makes a grand amount. Instruments happen and things like that. It's just
amazing.
It's really amazing when you read through the donations and realize how fortunate we are to be in this kind of community. Kudos to those folks, as always.
Yes.
Everything else is pretty normal.
Anything else with consent?
Mr. President, I'll make a motion to approve the consent agenda as presented.
It's been motion and second. All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Any opposed? None opposed. Passes 4-0. Approve the consent agenda. We could look at them all individually. Nah, let's check. All right. Public hearing. Study and voting session. There's a lot of items. So, number one, the budget for 2018-19. Mr. Moore, do you want to start that off?
Yep, we're in the first stages of starting. Well, actually, we started in January when we started looking at staffing and projected enrollments. And trying to predict how many kids we're going to have on average on the 100th day of school next year. And so this is the proposed budget for the fiscal year 19, the 18-19 school year. Just a couple things of note that we have the 20 by 20 new monies, which is bringing in about $1.1 million more than prior to that. And then also the inflation rates was bringing in the increase about 300,000 more. So with that being said, our budget is about 1.4 million more than what it was last year. Our tax rates is going up a little bit because we have more money that we need to raise. I kind of did a little feelers around and I didn't know how significant it is. And for those who I've talked to, Renee Rask at the county, they said it's nominal change. You shouldn't get too many more. But we are raising more money because we are one district that doesn't get any state equalization. So all of our MNO budget is raised by the taxpayers.
And how much is that going up?
It's about 1.4 million more.
Oh, I thought you would tell me percentage or
something. Well, yeah, so last year, our primary tax rate, which is what drives our M&O, last year is 1.49%. And that is on, if your house is assessed at $100,000, you only tax on $10,000. So if you take 2.4919% of 10,000, that's what you passed over.
And now it's going up to 2.6.
6337.
Okay,
2.6. So it's going up about 2600th of a percent.
2600th of a percent.
Yes. And like I said, it was good because our property values did go up for a second year in a row, so it didn't need to be as high because the values of the homes assessed, and mostly it's a lot of businesses. They raised quite a big lion's share of our budget. On the
Also on the budget sheet, there's a new section on there which specifically has us outlining what our this year teacher's average salary is, and then also what our estimated budget teacher average salary is for next year, which is 11% difference. PSD was fortunate enough to have the governing board recommend a 3% raise in April, and meeting and doing the numbers and meeting with school site liaisons, decided to take the new money's 8% combined with the 3 to make 11, and then redistribute to the classified employees and other groups that didn't have new monies come in, to bring them to more of a competitive and just right, especially with our classified, fixing the flat in our classified schedule.
I appreciate the fact that you highlighted that for us. That's very good. I don't know what you're trying to tell us with the little blue tags by certain numbers on the button.
Remember, blue is just represents that if you were on that Excel sheet and you clicked on a blue, it kicked it to a page that has instructions. So blue just means that there's instructions, and I click on blue a lot when I'm doing
your work with the state worksheet.
This is the state worksheets. Okay. So I have not highlighted or did anything on this except the club numbers.
And the reason this meeting is later than our usual meetings is because we're waiting for the state budget worksheet to come out.
Yeah, which was only about 2.5 weeks ago.
Recently came out, and everybody plugs in all the numbers. Now, philosophically, PUSD does our budget, our philosophy in April, which we'll talk about in the next item. But this is the legal piece that's actually plugging into all of that. And then we'll be back July 10th to do what?
To adopt this officially. This will give time for the public to review it.
Okay.
It'll go on our website. I will be publishing a statement on our front page of our website about our teacher raise, but I also want to highlight the raises across the rest of the employees, specifically, like I said, classified getting minimum 10%. There are some groups with the proposed schedule on item number 2. I won't explain. So, yeah.
We're going up to our average of 43,000 plus. That doesn't include 301. Does
correct.
It? And it doesn't include benefits.
Benefits is not something specifically that you add in for a salary. It's behind the scenes.
Right.
11% of their employees' ASRS is matched with the state that goes into their account, so it doesn't include all the
point of making it really looks like it's improving nicely.
It is.
That's good.
The only other thing of note is we will continue to pay bills all the way through August 30th, so it's very hard to calculate exactly what our carry forward is going to be. Just like last year, I estimated it to be about $900,000. It came in just around $1.3 million. As of right now, I'm estimating it to be $1.3 million, which is why in the next items we're proposing to use some of that savings efficiencies into personal raises. I know it will be higher than 1.3 when we start closing out purchase requisition, the purchase orders, and the money's not spent. It then gets freed up in that carry forward. So those are the two main things, carry forward take, and all of the new monies that are coming in.
Okay.
That's the proposed budget.
It's great news, especially considering the last few years where things have come in the last 5, 6, 7 years.
With our carry forward, our overall M&O budget is being estimated. Once again, this is on enrollment that hasn't happened yet, is a little over $26 million, and it was a little under $23 million last year.
So do you want a motion on considering?
Any other comments? Yep.
Mr. President, I move that we approve the proposed budget for 2018-2019 as presented.
Second.
It's been motioned and seconded. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Any opposed? Passes 4-0. All right. Number 2.
So we're budget package. Yeah, I mean, just approved. This is just sort of the legal piece that Evelyn Arizona does. Item number 2, as I mentioned earlier, is
sort of QSD's piece of our proactive budgeting. Where we start in January, and we look at the staffing model, and we look at what our staffing needs, and we work through this whole process that you're all very familiar with. And again, it's the board approving philosophically changes that we're making, additions that we're doing. That's when QSD's chosen to do that from kind of a place of transparency. Not every school district might do something like this. They just do item one. So as Brian mentioned, in April it was approved to give a 3% raise across the board. And like for the last 4 years, we've said, if the state gives us more money, we'll be back. And we've never come back until this year. And so that's a whole different wonderful story that we could talk about, how that came about, but we're in a great place with that. And I do want to point out that we have some of our teacher liaisons in the back that wanted to give us a wave. I point our liaisons out because they were instrumental in, one, standing up and making sure that our needs were heard, and two, working with us to look through our whole process and ask questions. They helped us to create a Q&A, which is part of this board packet, and they gave us some questions, and we tried to work through those and said, can we sit down and have you help us do this from a district standpoint? And so we came up with a Q&A, shared it with the whole entire district. It was a neat process, and I appreciated it greatly. I have to tell you, after we sent out those Q&A, I didn't have any more questions. We didn't have before that, we had people calling and saying, what in the world is going on? How are we doing this? It was a bit chaotic, which things like this are, because there was big change fast. So I appreciate the partnership. I appreciate the working together. We have plans to work together further in the future, just for all different issues, workplace issues and budgetary issues. But it's great to have staff involved and understanding and being able to explain that to other staff. So we're at a whole new place with that. So I've communicated with the board a lot about this philosophical piece, and Brian touched on it some, but the crux of it is that there's an 11% raise for teachers, a 10 to 20% raise for classified to fix the flattening of the salary schedule because of minimum wage, and a 5% to all other staff. I had dreamed of having this conversation, and I'm thrilled that it happened as quickly as it did. So, I could go on and on, but I think we've all kind of looked through this quite a bit, but we'll entertain any questions.
What did you say the classified range was on the percentage?
10 to 20.
Grade 4 and grade 5, the higher responsibility grades, will be getting the highest, because right now the highest is $12.67. Proposal is to go to $14.50. And they're the ones who'll see the 18 to 20% raises. When it's all said and done with minimum wage from where we were for the lower grades to $12, they'll see over the years about a 26 to 27% change in minimum wage. This fixes so many of our issues.
And it's important as the minimum wage goes up that we also keep moving other people up so it doesn't just, like I said, flat.
Until this point, we didn't have a fix.
This fixes it.
Yes.
Now, the hope is that we continue to get inflation money and add that when it needs to be added to remain competitive and fair and that whole type of thing. Part of the future of this, as we look forward, we believe strongly that we can do a 6% the next 2 years after this for teachers based on the 23% that the state gave us for teachers. But this is a pretty general fix that we thought would take us 3 to 4 years for classified. And that was a big piece with liaisons was, hey, let's use some of this money from the state, not just for teachers, but to fix some of these other issues. And so, I mean, a lot of school districts have not had an answer to this minimum wage issue. We found that answer, and if we continue to get inflation, we should be able to stay with it.
Agreed.
Well, I know in all the Red for Ed stuff over the last few months, which has been a roller coaster, to say the least, but out of it, you know, I know teachers, the initial thought was, it's all about their pay, but it was very clear. They they care for all the support staff, everybody that works in within the district and how important everybody is. And so this is great.
And our liaisons led with that through all of our conversation.
Good.
And that's the reason why this document looks extremely messy. But if anyone or the public wants to go over it, I will, because it breaks down. Here was our original April raise.
The 3%.
And then here's how we're getting those groups to the higher amounts. And it was intentionally laid out this way.
Who would have thought we'd be here 4 months ago? It's amazing.
Yep.
And we want PSD to be a place that employees want to stay, and they want to be here, they love being here. This is a big piece of it.
So, a motion.
Yeah, it's a good one.
I move that we approve the updated budget package based on new legislation for 11% teacher raise, a plan to fix the flat and classified salary schedule, minimum 10%, and 5% to all other staff, and to fund other outstanding physician needs as presented.
Second. Motion and second. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Any opposed? Passes 4-0. That's great.